Child and a six-pack of beer. I pondered that name for 15 minutes after I saw the poster stapled to a phone pole on the corner of Grand and 21st. That was a couple of years ago. I was already in my 40s then, so I didn't go out on a whim just to see a band named Alpha Male and the Canine Mystery Blood, just because I like the name, just as if I'm 25 and every day's a stone summer day. My band was always gigging then, REM was still kicking then. I drove that Ford Granada mom and dad gave to me after they got him, a Ford LTD, and there was music on MTV. I smoked my manager's pot. I got laid quite a lot by my standards. Planes hadn't flown into towers yet, and we hadn't had a loose cannon president yet. Didn't have all this credit card debt hanging over the house like a cloud, ensuring there's not a lot of drugging allowed. The body can't take it, the wallet can't hang. I'm singing all the songs I've sang for years, and when it's a band gig, it's rocking. And when it's solo, the people talking while I'm singing make me depressed. You think I could take a hint? My time came and went. There's many times I came and went in a manner of speaking. My conscience is leaking. The world has changed and the good times are gone. We get to be the poor fools who greet the dawn of this new age of fear, surveillance and sleaze and bombs in your carry-ons and way too many enemies. I bet their name was Menstrual Blood, and the A&R guy said, that's no good, you gotta change it to Mystery. Then we can target a broader-based goth dog lover market. I love my boy, he's becoming a drummer. He got a drum kit from Santa. At this rate, by summer, he'll be keeping a beat in a world that needs a metronome shoved up its ass so hard all voices will raise in a heavenly choir. Shit'll get straight, me and my brother'll hug. We'll dance like we did in the decade of the good drugs. I'm spitting my jeans in an ocean that's rising, clinging to Jesus with some compromising of how it was handed to me from my mom and my daddy, the preacher, who watched all that TV in a cream recliner, frowning through life like a stone hard liner. You could not faze the man. He knew Jesus died for his sins and was raised from the dead. And I've always wondered, why can't he stay dead? It doesn't change a single good thing he said. It was all St. Paul's trip, the resurrection. Why can't he just be a nice Jewish guy who was super clued in and showed us the way to salvation from sin? And that doesn't mean if you're not quote-unquote saved, you fry like a slice of country ham in your grave. It's a great big world. Love is a joke. Arabs and Christians, Pepsi and Coke, and people so gorgeous it causes them pain, and nobody gives any sympathy for something like that. You suffer in silence or form a band with a name that appeals to goth dog lovers everywhere on a poster that's seen by a 43-year-old bastard walking to work at 8:15, 11 an hour for all that he does. You can't be a has-been when you never was. Going all day long without eating till all of my nerve endings are seriously overheating and my legs are getting wobbly walking down the stairs to smoke another cig in the cold fresh air, wondering why I do the things I do, and I do them every day and it can't turn out good living this way, but live this life I must, and in some fuzzy God I'll trust, I'll kiss my wife, I'll kiss my son, and maybe someday I'll go for a run. Maybe someday a song will stick. I'll walk around like I got a big boat. Maybe someday my boy will drum in a hippie jam band that plays out some. He'll take after daddy and get in a van, go to places only young people can, doing things only young people do, banging those skins at Bonnaroo, rocking the dreadheads, dancing in the mud before Alpha Male and the Canine Mystery Blood. God go with him,